Merry Christmas and a happy new...
It's not Christmas!
Well, it's Christmas in Fortnite, as far as anyone else is concerned, because we just got word of a bucket load of new skins coming to the game.
Wow!
Yes, Fred, I'm excited too. So excited, in fact, that I've decided to show the real gamers all of the leaks.
Yeah!
So get it together, people. And hey, if you like any of these skins, be sure to use code T5G when they come out. It helps support the channel. And at your number 10 spot, we've got the Llama Hero. Llama Hero is an upcoming skin that seems to grab the Bright Bomber and Bright Gunner skins, mash them together, and then get the Rainbow Smash pickaxe and just hammer it to make a head. Basically, it's a mashup of the Bright set, and it looks pretty darn cool. It even comes with two variants if you want to switch it up and take those rainbow colors away. Anyway, the Llama Her...
I have a name, you know!
Sorry, Fred, but this isn't you. Look, this llama has rainbows on it and a unicorn horn, and even a mohawk. You're not that cool.
What? Yes, I am. I'll prove it.
Yep, I knew it. This skin is too cool to be Fred, and that's why you can pick it up using code T5G when it appears in the item shop in the coming weeks. If not Season 11, we still have way too many leaked cosmetics and not enough days for all of them to appear in the shop, meaning that some of the cosmetics on this list could be coming to Season 11, maybe in the new Battle Pass or maybe in the shop. Who knows? Only time will tell. Number 9, the Bright Gunner Remix. You know how we were just talking about Bright Gunner? Well, here it is again. This is the Bright Gunner Remix skin, and it's coming to Fortnite in the future. I know what you're thinking. Well, T5G, we get a lot of free variants for skins that we already own, like the VR fish stick or the helmets for Mission Specialist and Moonwalker. But unfortunately, if you want this Bright Gunner Remix, you're gonna have to buy it all over again. That's right. This is its own skin, like the Summer Drift or that despicable Gunner backbling that everyone caused Epic to backtrack on. This is a redesign that you have to pay for rather than get as a variant. It sucks, but that is how it is. It's a pretty cool redesign, to be honest. We don't yet know how much it will cost, but hopefully it's not too much. The set will also come with dual pickaxes that have bright and rainbow-themed designs on them. Number 8 is the Militia Mascot Cuddle. Here's an upcoming skin bundle that looks pretty solid. Like, this is one of my favorites in the list purely because of the skin design. Let me introduce you to the Militia Mascot Cuddle Bundle. Selection of 4 Cuddle Team Leader skins and some sort of military gear and helmet that looks like something someone in the Purge would wear. For the fact that this is a skin with 3 variants, we can assume that we'll see it for between 1,500 and 2,000 V-Bucks in the item shop, like the Beast Mode skins that had 3 variants. And the upcoming Bow Bro skin. At that price? For 4 skins? What a steal. I'm definitely picking this up when it appears in the future. The Militia Mascot Cuddle actually appears in a leaked loading screen, so we can assume it's coming to the shop very, very soon. Get those V-Bucks ready and that wallet prepared. Number 7, Sushi Ninja. The Sushi Ninja, first of all, how do you come up with this stuff, Epic? Do you get a sushi chef and give them some ninja clothing? What is this? What are we doing here? And either way, though, this is the Sushi Ninja skin, and it's coming to an item shop near you. She reminds me of the Kuno skin and the Sushi Master skin, of course, which is kind of the most obvious combo you can think of when you look at this. But hey, that's what it is. We don't know when she's coming to the shop, maybe in Season 11 or maybe in the coming days. We'll have to wait and see. But in at number 6, we've got the Street Fashion Red. Now, this is a really dope skin. I'm a massive fan personally of this. Introducing Street Fashion Red, an upcoming outfit that's going to be in the item shop for between 1,000 and 1,500 V-Bucks. Aside from looking really pleasing with the shades of red and that really cool baseball cap, this skin is just a simple but cool looking design. What do you think though? Let us know in the comments. I'd love to know if you agree with me on this one. It's a banger of an outfit in my opinion. I'll definitely be buying this once it hits the item shop. The description for Street Fashion Red is summon your fighting spirit, and this has been leaked before the official update is out at the time of recording this. We don't know what other items will be included in the item skin set, if any at all, but I can't wait to find out more regardless. Number 5 is the Racer. You know the taxi skin? Well, that skin's female version, Whiplash, seems to be getting an upgrade. And no, it's not from taxi to Uber. She's now a racer. Again, this is a separate skin compared to the original, which means you'll have to shell out V-Bucks purely if you want this tiny redesign, which kind of sucks. I wish this was just a variant, but apparently not. Hopefully she only costs like 800 V-Bucks. Otherwise, that would be a massive ripoff. Come on, Epic. I have faith in you, I think. Number 4, the Tactical Red. I personally don't really like this skin, but if you're a fan of this, by all means, you can pick it up when it comes to the item shop sooner or later. This is Tactical Red, an upcoming skin that seems to be inspired by Elite Agent and the Shogun skin. She has some pretty cool sleeve tattoos and some elements of her costume are cool, but I don't see myself buying this one. Hey, let us know what you think, though. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments, especially if you have a favorite skin that you'll be buying, hopefully using code T5G because we love you and you love us, right? At the end of the day, it's down to personal preference, and Tactical Red might suit the needs of pro players who want a skin that can't be seen from 10 miles away, like Galaxy or something, but there's a skin for everyone. And this one is coming soon. Maybe in Season 11. Maybe tomorrow.
It's a mystery.
Number 3. Yellow Camo A, B, C, and D. Okay, so oddly enough, these skins were all found separately in the files, which means they aren't variants of each other. At least that's what we can gather from the leaks. So Yellow Camo A, B, C, and D are all separate skins. We're assuming, and I'm guessing, that it'll be like the soccer of NFL skins, where there's a shop full of different versions that you can pick what you want. All 4 Yellow Camo skins are male and are different characters wearing the same clothes, with even the same tattoos and dirt marks. When I see the Yellow Camo, I get a 21 Pilots 5, and I think that's pretty cool, but I personally wouldn't buy more than one of these guys, especially if they're something like 1,200 V-Bucks a piece, if not more. Oh my god. I do see myself buying one of these, though, if the price is right, as they are pretty cool. What's your favorite out of the 4 yellow camo dudes? Number 2. Rogue Spider Knight. Rogue Spider Knight isn't just a variant. He isn't just a skin either. He's a fully fledged challenge pack similar to that of the Fallen Love Ranger or the Breakpoint pack. Basically, these things are like $10 and you get a free legendary skin along with the challenges to unlock up to 1,000 V-Bucks. However, what's interesting about the Rogue Spider Knight challenge pack is that the leaks suggest that you'll be able to unlock more than just 1,000 V-Bucks with the challenges. Completing them will give you 2 additional styles for the skin. The challenges are playing a match of Battle Royale, landing in different named locations, searching chests, and joining a creative server. Completing the challenges will earn you the black style and green style for the skin, as well as the Rogue Spider shield backbling that comes with it. Most basic challenges on the planet. I know, right? No wonder they don't give out V-Bucks. But the pack does this, right? You also get 2,000 V-Bucks with the pack. But don't get your hopes up yet. I may have said that packs usually cost $10 earlier, but this isn't your usual pack. The Rogue Spider Knight will be exclusive to a certain Xbox One S bundle that releases this week. It is not already out yet by the time you're watching this. You have to buy a console for this bundle. Not the best deal looking at it now, eh? Better than nothing, though. And it's free with an Xbox, I guess. Honorable mention number 1 is Game Boy, but there's more. Now, a Game Boy backbling already exists in the Season 10 Battle Pass in the form of a gameplay. But we'll be getting color variants for the gameplay and backbling. According to leaks, we're going to be able to unlock a red and gray variant for it. But how, you ask? Well, it seems that overtime challenges are coming back for yet another season. These overtime challenges will reward you with styles for Eternal Voyager, DJ Yonder, and Sparkle Supreme. The challenges themselves haven't leaked yet, so stay tuned for that. If you're keeping an eye out, the overtime challenges are likely to begin once the final weekly challenges have been out for a week, and then it's the end game. I cannot wait. Honorable mention number 2 is the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 skin. Yet we all knew this was coming. Let's be honest, there's always a Samsung skin. We've had 2, and now we're on the 3rd. Galaxy was the first exclusive phone skin. Now Samsung and Epic are teaming up for the 3rd time to bring Glow to the world. Not much is known about Glow, other than the fact that she'll be redeemable on the 27th of September.
Apparently.
And you can redeem her with a Note 9 or 10, S9 or S10, and a few other phones. She looks pretty sweet for an exclusive phone skin. And I'm 16 Iconics doing the scenario emote everywhere. It'll be nice to see a new exclusive skin that everybody wears. Honorable mention number 3 is the Joker. This sits in our honorable mention list because it's speculation more than it is a leak. If you look in the challenges for the Fortnite x Batman event, you can see that one challenge requires you to find and defuse 3 Joker gas canisters around the map. Not to mention, you can find Joker-related graffiti all over the Gotham City POI. At first, it looks like a shout-out to the villain rather than a hint, although it might still be. Leakers found files for a male and female skin that is codenamed Jester. We still don't know what they are, and while they could be Jester skins, they could also be a Joker and Harley Quinn skin. I'm not getting my hopes up. It's always the realm of possibility, though. You never know with Fortnite anymore. He did a crossover with Jumpman. Jumpman! These guys are unpredictable, so really nothing's off the table anymore. Besides, the new Joker movie comes out next week, so it's even more likely. But again, just speculation for now. And it's your number 1 spot, we've got Cupid. We all know Love Ranger, that awesome stone statue of Cupid that appears in the shop way too often, even though it's a Valentine's Day skin. Yeah, that's the one. Well, a new leak shows that a female Love Ranger is coming. Yep, I've actually been wanting a female Love Ranger for quite a long time in IRL 2. And seeing this leak, dang. I cannot wait to buy this. She'll likely appear in Season 11, as the only leaks we have of her are in-game and not file-related. So we'll have to see. I'm guessing she'll appear in the item shop along with the male Love Ranger, as Epic usually do when releasing opposite-gender skins. I cannot wait for this, though. This skin looks pretty rockin'. It'll likely be 2,000 V-Bucks like Love Ranger when it hits the shop. But hey, you can't click off the video yet, because you have to watch this one on screen right now. There's an annotation. You gotta click it. If you don't click it, Fred's gonna explode. Actually, maybe he won't if you don't click the button. Or maybe Just click it. Do it. You didn't click the annotation, did you? I'm mad.
Keep it here on Top 5 Gaming.